My mom called out, "Ven acá y léeme esta carta de la aseguranza." My mom handed me an insurance letter she wanted me to translate for her. I took the letter and started reading it. At first glance, I was blown away. There were words such as premiums, policy declaration, and indemnity, which I had no clue of what they meant. In fact, this behind me is an actual insurance letter just to show you how intimidating one can be. I knew I couldn't tell my mom I didn't understand, because if I did, she would say, "But mija, you know English and you're in middle school. How can you not understand it?" Therefore, I decided just to read it and act as if I knew what the letter was saying. At this moment, I was language brokering. You all may be asking yourselves, what in the world is a language broker? A language broker is a child of immigrants who translates or interprets for their family members, or AKA me. In this picture, I was about 8 or 9, and to the best of my memory, I have been language brokering since. When I first learned about this term, I wondered, isn't a language broker the same as an interpreter? The answer is no. The difference between an interpreter and a language broker is that interpreters are trained professionals. Because language brokers are not professionals, they may not interpret the information accurately, which can lead to serious consequences. In the medical setting, it can even lead to death, as with the case of Julio Perez. Julio still remembers the day that changed his life forever. He and his 5-year-old brother, Aldo, had both gotten sick. Their parents took them to the doctors where they were given a shot. Julio got better, but Aldo did not. Their mother then took them to a hospital where an interpreter was summoned to explain liability forms. Once the forms were signed, the interpreter left and never returned. "I had to be the interpreter," says Julio. As he remembers, doctors said that his brother had a serious bacterial infection. Numerous procedures passed as doctors tried to save Aldo's life. He died on April 12, 2008. "I feel that my baby brother's death was an injustice," says Julio Perez. Language brokering in the medical setting has received much attention in recent years, and with the serious outcomes it can have, such as with Julio's case, it is no wonder this issue has become so controversial. This leads me to the research I assisted Dr. Lisa Gunspiller with. I studied the health literacy levels of children and language brokers, and an example of health literacy is being able to read the prescription labels on the medications. Low English proficiency patients are especially at risk, given they must overcome both English and health literacy barriers. Therefore, many of them use their children to obtain the doctor's information by language brokering. At age 17, I also interpreted for my dad in the doctor's office after his work accident. His boss accidentally crushed his foot with a tractor, which basically broke it. I interpreted for my dad various times after the accident, but there is one day I will never forget. The doctor was going to take the gauze off for the first time and clean my dad's foot. Once he started to take the gauze off, I turned away because my dad's facial expression screamed pain. About 6 seconds later, I heard the kind of sound that meat makes when you take it apart, and I thought the worst and about puked. I felt ashamed, nauseated, and sorry for my dad. Even though he was the one who was suffering, I couldn't even be strong enough to stay in the room and finish interpreting for him. As you can see, language brokering in the medical settings at times can result in unwanted outcomes. For the child, it may be a very sensitive and embarrassing situation, especially if they're dealing with delicate information about their parents. And for the parent, language brokering could be life-threatening if the information is not accurately interpreted. To conclude, I would like you all to imagine that you're the parents of Julio Perez. What would you want native English speakers to know about your situation? Having been placed in the position of a language broker, and I say placed because I did not choose to be one, it would have been nice if more people were understanding with me, and to know that language brokering is not the easiest thing for a child to do. For me, I wouldn't want my language brokering story to have been left untold. What about you?